police officers know how to de-escalate when there's a white woman who has shot somebody, let's say her husband, and she still has a gun and refuses to drop it. Here's the video.
Drop the gun!
Drop the gun!
You got any eyes, El Sarge?
What's that?
You got any eyes?
I can't see.
She's sitting right behind the bed.
Yeah, but she's on the other side of the bed.
Oh, I think
it's a black revolver.
I said a visitor. Drop the gun!
Drop the gun! Drop the gun!
Just drop it. Just put it on the ground and slide it away from you.
Drop the gun!
No, no, no.
I got you. I got you.
You can't open from the outside. Hey, here.
Yes.
You want to crack this open with this? Can you open it from the outside?
Yes, you open it down from the outside.
Drop the gun!
Watch out. We got time. Pack up. Back up. We got time. We got nothing but time, guys. Can we evacuate some patients from the adjoining rooms? Can we do that or not?
Drop the gun, man!
I got a good angle right here.
Drop the gun!
What's this guy in here for?
Drop the gun!
Man, hold on. You got to build dialogue. Man, tell me what's going on. Tell me what's going on. I don't want to hurt you. Tell me what's going on. Just talk to me. Talk to me. What's going on? Why can't you drop the gun? Why can't you drop the gun?
Let's put up a picture for a mass. One of the statements you heard the police say, we got nothing but time. Another officer said, hey, I got the angle right here. No. No, we got nothing but time. Okay? You know how many times I've said that on this show? I've said, listen, you all have nothing but time. Wait it out. They're not going anywhere. I'm highlighting this story not to suggest that this woman should be dead, even though she killed her husband and still had the gun in her hand when the police came and refused lawful commands to disarm herself. What I am saying is that the countless black and brown folk that have been killed by law enforcement without a gun had no weapon. The police didn't have time for them. Those who were experiencing a mental health crisis, like the story we just covered, the police did not have all day for them. But they had all day for Miss Gilland. Miss Ellen Gilland. She was repeatedly instructed to drop her gun after she killed her husband in that room. She shot and killed her husband, Jerry, who was ill, then refused commands to put down the gun. She has been charged with first degree murder and assault with a deadly weapon. She is being held without bond, but she will receive what the Constitution mandates. Due process. She will get it. She will receive due process. Now, why do you think these cops have so much patience here? The woman has already demonstrated she's willing to kill. I thought they were in fear of their lives. The woman has demonstrated in that moment that she is not willing to listen to a lawful command. She has a gun, knows how to use it, has already used it. Somebody's dead, somebody else could die. They have patience. Why? Because when they looked at her, put a picture. Put a picture back up. When they looked at her, they saw her humanity. They saw their mothers, their grandmother, their aunt. They saw people that they value inside of her. Once again, I'm not saying she should be dead, even though it would have been well within protocol and the law to do so. What I am saying is that when officers see you as a human being, that's what it looks like. That's what it looks like. When they do not, well, we got plenty of examples of what that looks like, right? You can't train that out of a cop. You have to literally recruit a different culture of police in order for humanity to be at the forefront of the decision making. Let me give you the details. According to the police report, staff heard what sounded like a gunshot. And three people entered the room to see this woman holding a black revolver handgun, which she had aimed at them. Okay. They told police they observed the victim laying unresponsive on the bed in a pool of blood, and the suspect with the gun demanding they exit the room. The sound of gunfire in the hospital prompted calls for help, frightened employees, unsure of the situation, doing what they could do to hide and protect patients and themselves. Standoff details. Eventually, this woman, Ms. Gilland, dropped her weapon and was brought out of the hospital after she was detained. But police say that they had to use a flash bang device to distract her and then a taser, which was ineffective. She allegedly fired one more shot that hit the ceiling before dropping the weapon. She was not killed. The Daytona Beach Police Department said an investigation revealed the couple from New Smyrna Beach planned this weeks ago. They said the pair made a pact to go through with a murder-suicide 3 weeks ago if the husband, who was terminally ill, continued to take a turn for the worst. Wow. All right. Thoughts here, Sharon?
Well, let's start with after they spared her life, and she apparently exhibited this superhuman strength that normally we only hear about from black men. Okay, they had to do it. But what I heard infuriates me, Dr. Richey, because it was really speaking her love language. I heard a love song. I heard that. I wrote it down. We got nothing but time. I got a good angle. I mean, they were really speaking. Tell me what's going on. I don't want to hurt you, baby. Yep. Okay, right. I threw in the baby. They can have all the time in the world when it looks like their mother, sister, wife, whatever. But when it's an unarmed black man or a black man in mental health crisis, you're right. Not their love language.
No patience, no love, nothing. All right. Once again, not saying she should be dead, but I'm saying there's a whole lot of other folks that should be alive.